This video was sponsored by Skillshare. Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this cartoon effect for any video or photo using only Photoshop. After following this tutorial, you will create your own cartoon effect PSD file. And with that file, you will be able to cartoonize any video or photo within 5 seconds. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the cartoon effect. Let's start by creating a new document. Change width to 1920 pixels, height to 1080 pixels with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. Go to File, place Embedded to import your video. Choose your video, then click Place. Resize your video to fill the canvas if needed, then press Enter to confirm. As you can see, the video has been imported as a smart object. Now go to Window, Timeline to open the Timeline panel. Click on the Create Video Timeline button, and this will open up a very basic video timeline like that. You can navigate through your video by moving this slider. This video is lagging a little bit because it's a 4K video. You can zoom in or out through the timeline from here. And you can also run the video or split it right here. But all I need right now is to select the video layer and apply some filters to it. Let's start by applying the Smart Sharpen filter from here. Change amount to 200%, radius to 1.5, reduce noise to 0 with removing Gaussian blur. Then click OK. This will increase the sharpness and clarity of your video. Since we're working with a smart object, all filters will be applied as a smart filter, like that. Now with your layer selected, go to Filter, Stylize, and choose Oil Paint. In some Photoshop versions, you may find it right here. If your oil paint filter is missing or doesn't work, please check this video description below. Now let's apply it from here. Change stylization to 2, cleanliness to 1, scale to 0.1, bristle detail 0, and uncheck lighting. This will add a simple oil paint effect like that. Click OK and let's continue. With your layer selected, go and open the Filter Gallery window. And under the Artistic folder, choose the Poster Edge filter. Change it to 0, 1, and 6. This will add some black outlines to your video like that. Double-click on this little icon to open the filter blending options. Decrease opacity to 10% and click OK. Now let's apply the poster edge filter again. But this time change it to 0, 0, and 2. This will separate each color into different tones like this. Click OK, then double-click on this little icon to change its opacity to 40%. Now go to Filter, Blur, and choose Surface Blur. Change Radius to 15 and Threshold to 7, then click OK. Reapply the Oil Paint filter with the same previous values. Just click OK, and let's add the final filter. From the Sharpen menu, choose the Unsharp Mask filter. Change amount to 130%, Radius to 3, and Threshold to 2. These values will sharpen your final result and boost the cartoon effect details. Click OK and let's see the before and after. Now let's talk about our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of inspiring classes for all creative and curious people. They have tons of premium classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes for Photoshop only. One class that I really love is the Photoshop Advanced Training Course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. All this is less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. Plus, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Now let's move to step 2, adjustments. First, drag this slider to the very beginning like that. Make sure that it's standing at frame 0. Select your layer, and let's make a levels adjustment layer from here. As you can see, whatever you add in the layers panel will be shown in the timeline like that. Now let's change the highlights to 250, midtones to 1.1, and leave shadow 0. Let's create a vibrance layer. Change vibrance to plus 20 and saturation to plus 10. Create a color lookup layer. Change it to 3-step.look. Change the blending mode to overlay and opacity to 25%. Finally, let's make a selective color layer. I usually use the selective colors to adjust whites, neutrals, and blacks. Here are the values that I use for those three colors. You don't have to stick to these values. Just use whatever adjustment layer you want, with any values you like. Now let's delete the background layer and save the final project for any future use. Just go to File and click on Save As. Give a name to your file and make sure that the file extension is PSD. Now let's move on to the final step. Step 3, rendering and reapplying the effect with a click. To render this video, you can do this from this little icon. Or just go to File, Export, and choose Render Video. Name the exported file as you like. Select a folder from your PC to render inside it. And leave all other settings as the same as mine. Then click Render. Wait a few minutes for the render to finish. This full HD 20 seconds video took me around 10 minutes to render. This will depend on your video length, size, and your PC specifications. Now let's reapply the same effect on a new video. Just double-click on the layer thumbnail to open it. Once you are inside your smart object, go and select the existing video layer and import the new video above it from here. Choose any video you want and click Place. Press Enter and delete the bottom video group. Now press Ctrl and S to update your smart object. Get back to your main document. And here is the final result. You can render it as before and cartoonize any new video or photo by updating the smart object only. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.